So before we start this year, I want to take a quick poll, and not everyone has to speak up. Does anyone know the reason why we have this event or have a question about why we have it? First time being at it, at this event, by all means, say something.
This is my first time.
Mine too.
So to give a little history on this day and why it's so important to us, you know, it's usually very rare when you get a community playing a video game to kind of go beyond just the game and kind of start impacting ourselves in real life. And back in the first year of the Guilds operation, back in 2007, one of those individuals that kind of affected the lives of a lot of people in our community was a fellow by the name of Milliway, known in Meatspace, of course, as Bruce Galloway. And Bruce was one of those very rare individuals that if you needed help, whether it be some in-game event or you just needed money or you just needed someone to talk to because you were having a rough day in real life, he was one of those guys who, you know, would sit there and goes, hey, yeah, tell me about it. Well, you know, maybe I can help out. So he was really eager to give of himself. Really, really great guy. Very, very generous. You couldn't say anything bad about him because there was nothing really bad to say about him. And he became a fixture in our group very early on. And I had the privilege of getting to know him once at an actual real-life meetup, which, by the way, if you ever get a chance to do that, meet your guildies in real life, by all means do. Because it's nice to see to get to know the individuals between the cartoons, the pixels behind the screen, because it helps build that community outside of just a silly little video game. So we were getting our preparations ready for BlizzCon for that year. And about a month before, Millie just disappeared. And Millie says, hey, what's going on? Millie's gone. And we couldn't figure out what happened. And through another fellow person in the guild named Toshika, who was also a friend of him, we found out that he had been taken to the hospital, hospitalized, because he had had a ruptured aorta. And they were able to stop it, but he required surgery in order to try to repair it. And I remember going in there, seeing them a couple days before the surgery, and actually the day before the surgery as well, just to kind of see how he was doing. And he was all laughs, and he was still laughing, even though he knew how really serious and how really dangerous this procedure was at the time. And he was just smiling, goes, hey, I'll see you in game in a week or so. And the next day, I had left work and I was driving home. Not that I would ever recommend you ever using your cell phone as you're driving, but I was driving towards the freeway and I'd call the hospital and I'd ask, you know, oh, can I please speak to Bruce Galloway? And I was told, I'm sorry, we don't have a patient by that name. So I'm like, oh, well, maybe they made a mistake. Maybe that there was some error as hospitals sometimes are prone to do. And with that, it hadn't even been 5 minutes and I got a phone call from his mom who had that told me that Bruce hadn't survived the surgery. And I'm trying really hard not to choke up.
Sorry about that.
So when I made an immediate beeline home and I let the officers know and we said, hey, Bruce didn't make it through the surgery, you know, he's passed on. And we started letting folks in the guild know. And in a period of about, say, 30, 40 minutes, all of us were on this hill. Laughing, joking, crying, just talking about how great a guy Millie was. And we knew that this was going to sooner or later happen within the community. People come, people go, we lose people. It's just the way of life. But we took it upon that day to always remember Bruce and all those fellow folks who used to play these silly little video games, silly little cartoon characters jumping around, because it really isn't about these silly cartoons that you play with. It is the relationships that we make in game, the people we look forward to talking with, sharing silly jokes, sharing baby photos, discussing about, oh my God, it was a horrible day, or I went to the beach, or man, I really shouldn't have had that extra vodka tonic that one night. But I also remember another conversation that I had had with Millie the night we had met for the first time in real life. And he said, you know, I have this vision for AIE. And that vision is that, you know, one day WoW is going to come and go. And we've built something very, very special with us, because unlike the usual kind of like asshattery, douchebaggery, just general mean-spirited that you see in a lot of other gaming communities and a lot of other areas online, AI is special because instead of trying to tear each other up and just to get our jollies, we actually try to help each other out. We pass it forward. We have developed what we oftentimes refer to as the martyr loot system, where it's like, instead of having fights over that piece of loot belongs to me, it's you take it. No, you take it. And I've seen the same generosity happen in real life, where people will say, no, you have this. No, take this, take that. You know, trinkets, baubles, whatever it is. It's just that giving spirit that's made us special. And he said back to Bruce that wouldn't it be great if we can replicate this environment in every game that we get involved in? And I thought, you know, that's pretty ambitious. That's a goal. We can look into it. And this was like this was the early days of AIE. And once his passing, we made it a point to try to make that happen. And since then, we're fighting dragons with each other. We're fighting in the cold confines of space, being space diplomats and tyrants, discovering new lands, taking over markets, manipulating individuals, just spreading the wonderfulness that is the AIE to the rest of the other games that we've decided to get involved in. Much to the chagrin of our critics, because a lot of them have said, that's never going to happen. You're just a bunch of like casual poors who don't understand, who don't get the idea of what leaked play video game them is. Well, funny that if they say that, because many of our critics have now done and gone, and we now look ourselves in a position where we find ourselves to be the old man on the server. And WoW, we have survived in the hyper-competitive world of EVE Online. We've traveled the stars in SOTOR. We've discovered new areas in Final Fantasy XIV. And in every other game that is just too long to list right now because I'll be here for the rest of the evening, we've shown them that there is a better way. A way that takes into consideration respect, kindness, and just general can-doism that you don't see in a lot of other gaming communities. Trust me, I've witnessed it. This doesn't happen. This is truly unique. So I would like to say that Millie's experiment is a success, but it's not complete success, because we're looking at a gaming landscape that's ever evolving and ever changing, and we ourselves need to evolve and change along with it. We all know, you know, WoW will never be here forever, though it's been around for 10 years. A lot of the games that we are actually now in are going past the 5+ year mark. So we need to look at new avenues and new opportunities out there to present themselves to kind of spread the culture and the way of playing games that no one still even to this very day adopts or even imitates. So this day is not only to remember Bruce and all those who came after us, but to consider those who have yet to know us and to spread the word of what AIE is. And with that said, I would like to take my first volunteer victim who would like to speak up in regards to the particular game that they're involved in. No one speaks.
Before they get going, this is Ralph.
Yep.
This community is pretty amazing. We think about it. The game's been out for 10 years. Our guild is over 8 years old. Is that right?
Yep, it's over 8 years old.
And it's amazing to me how long it's been and how many friends I have from this area. And how many games we've got into. And like Lank said, there are other guilds out there that think of themselves as mega guilds. But they do have a very different model than ours. They tend to be more franchise models, where each little instance of their guild. It's kind of its own little separate thing. And we're kind of like this mega guild that still is closer to a single entity. At least in WoW. We have the other games, and I think the style of guild that we have has gone over into those other games as well. And I've certainly played my share of those games. And I think that's by design. We try to keep it that way. And I think that's a wonderful thing about this. I think about all the real life friends that I have from all my time in this guild. And it really is, I want to remember today not just the people that we've lost, but the friendships over the last 10 years. That's all.
Amen to that.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Oh, I'm sorry. Like, this is Tenchel. And I just want to say that when I first started playing this game, it was because my kids played it, and we never had any time with them because they're always in a dungeon. And I hated WoW with all that was good and holy. And then finally, after many, many months of not being able to just see my kids, my wife and I decided, well, if we can't beat them, we'll join them. And we have never looked back. And since we got in, we discovered, thanks to my son, we discovered AIE. And me being the advanced age that I am, I appreciate the maturity of the members in this this fine family. And one of the things that I know that Millie put forth that we do in his honor is the craft fair. And everybody that knows me knows that I don't do raids or dungeons because when I go in, the wrong people die. And but the craft fair has become my raid group. And my wife and I have both had the opportunity to meet some of our guildmates in real life. And Link is totally right. If you have the opportunity to get to a meet up or something, try to do it best you can, because we met the great guys in Phoenix, of which they are legion. And then, of course, we had a meeting here at our house of Cy and a lot of the craft fair people. And that was an absolute just wonderful experience. And for a guy that's, like I said, my advanced age, be hobnobbing with you 20-somethings, makes me feel young. Thank you. I'm 71 going on 39 right now. Thank you.
I forgot to mention one thing, is that Scott can't be here tonight, but he definitely messaged me a bunch of times about how much he hates to miss it. And I know a whole bunch of people were just recently at Nerdtacular, which is kind of like an AIE meetup in a lot of ways. And I wasn't able to be there this year, and I really missed it. But all you folks that went, I'm really glad you did. I hope you have lots of pictures to put on the web. But I just want to say that Scott does miss being here.
Yeah, I miss, like, this year I missed going to Nerdtacular. New job, which with no vacation time. So I get to miss out again. But just to add to this, and a lot of you people have heard me say this, where for the past 7 years, whenever I do take vacation and time off, it's never to go do something that, you know, say some kind of family obligation. It always ends up being a, who do I know in this neighborhood that plays video games with me that I want to go ahead and meet? So I've been to places like Washington and Oregon, New York and New Jersey, Maryland, Vermont, Washington, D.C.
Washington, D.C.
D.C. folks. And I always make it a point saying, hey, I'm going to be in a neighborhood. And sure enough, there's always at least one or two people that I always meet up that I've talked to or got to know, where we just sit there and we just share funny, ridiculous stories and go, or they go ahead and like show me what makes their world tick. And that's always really amazing.
And if I can say briefly, this is Anvil. My husband and I play, and we felt so comfortable with this guild, and And we like the people so much that we even have our 9-year-old playing with us. And he is a member of the guild. And I feel like this is a group of people where he can be involved in the game as we monitor him and play with him. But he's gone off with Grimcow to help get some stuff for his hunter. And he's done things like that. And I feel like this is a very safe environment where he can engage in the game and be with us. So I want to thank the community for that, because I do feel that this is a great group of people.
Say, who else can I go ahead and see? Are there any other like directors from games in today?
Yeah, I know we had Abbo and we had Max.
Abbo, I know Abbo can't talk. Max, would you like to say a couple of things?
Sure. And Pell's here too. I'm very proud of the group we have in Star Wars: The Old Republic. We're all here on Alderaan in our typical meeting spot that we've gathered in the last few years. Since Star Wars started up as a branch off of one of the second or third games or fourth games that we ended up going into. And this is always an amazing event. It's certainly hard losing friends and family. So getting together like this, I think, is a really great way to remember them and a great way to honor them. I also think they'd really be honored by the continued friendship and family that persists across AAE, including things like, as Ralph mentioned, Nerdtacular. I had a great time meeting a whole bunch of people out there. We had another good picture. I also think there's some other great things happening, like guildies getting married, even very recently, to each other. That's pretty amazing.
Like a couple days ago?
Yeah, exactly. Babies being born and new guildies showing up that way. That's pretty amazing. So I think all of that, and you know, kids coming in, people getting together, our virtual family and real families sort of coming together like that is pretty amazing. So all of that really makes me very happy to be part of AIE.
Amen.
Soon we'll have it'll be long enough that we can have a baby that was born from two guildies actually be playing one of the games.
That would be pretty amazing.
Soon.
Tia.
Well, like Randy and Samantha's boy can probably play pretty soon.
What do you mean? He's already playing. That's crazy. So I see Pels here. I see Hoots here. Any two fine gentlemen would like to say something?
Sure. I'm only just recently back from my computer blowing up and a lot of chaos going on, but it's good to be welcomed back during this absence, and I always look forward to this event. I've been around probably since 2007 or so, so I've seen all of these in a couple different games. We've done this in Lord of the Rings Online also, and it's just amazing how we've kind of spread out and continue to grow the community, and you know, we're still kind of doing this every single year. It's amazing that we've got all these people and that everyone is really friendly, and we're not, you know, just that we do things like this. It's a really cool thing, and not a lot of people can say that. So yeah, short and sweet, that's me.
So I don't want to put total Hoots totally on the spot, but I'm totally going to put him on the spot.
He does it all the time.
it's a new hobby.
But actually, you know, going off of what Pell was saying.
Oops, someone's hot biking.
All right, I like going off what Pell was saying. Ooh, someone is hot biking, and I wonder if it's me.
It is.
No, I think it was Tinchel, and I just muted her temporarily. Okay. I think that'll help.
I think I joined back in, around 2007, 2008. But the real great thing about this community is just how many play styles it really does accommodate. Like between the years 2007 and what I would say 2011, 2012, whenever I started, 2011 is when I started playing EVE. When I was playing Warcraft and was in Warcraft and AIE, it was always just this monolithic, giant, and awesomely friendly community where you never ran into anyone who was a jerk, which was really incredible. And you get all different types of play styles. Like myself, like for the first couple of years, I wasn't really vocal. And kind of the beautiful thing about AIE is just how accepting people are of everyone. Even nutters like me that play World of Warcraft like a single player game. We don't have to be part of a raid team or have like an epic gear score, or in EVE, you don't have to have like a 90% killboard efficiency. You just, it's really great, and it's something you don't see in a lot of places. And it was always just such a breath of fresh air, to kind of what was out there in gaming landia.
I know is that when the officership back, the proto officership back when we were first starting it back in the my baby days, there was a lot of discussion of what we wanted to do with this group. And there were some folks who were more like, well, we should have limits, we should have skills, we should have, like, you know, these kind of like artificially made like requirements that makes it difficult for people to show up and play. And the rest of us kind of sat there and said, no, it shouldn't be about how high you are on DPS meters, or if you've done this fight and you watch the videos and or whatever level of quote unquote, you know, game eliteness that you had. We were going to do something better. We may not get there as fast, but it didn't matter because we were having fun. Anyone else would like to say something? Now would be the time.
I'll speak up real quick.
Belthaz, ladies and gentlemen, the founder, creator, the mastermind behind the AIE Guildhall.
Hi guys, I'm Belthaz. Just wanted to take a minute. I know life happens and we get distracted and we move on from the game, but events like this always seem to bring us back together. There's a community here that I think is actually stronger than family. I'd rather hang out with you folks than a lot of my blood relatives. So thank you for being here, and thank you for being part of my life.
Here, here. Amen.
Man, what the heck are you?
And speaking about people, putting people under the spotlight, I would like to go ahead and point out Beefmaster this year. The fellow who usually, I'm one of the crazy idiots running around organizing this thing. But as many of you know or don't know, I recently even gotten, well, my life exploded too, new job and grad school, which has really impeded a lot of my ability to play an awful lot. So Beefmaster, I would like to go ahead and basically say thank you for organizing it this year and getting all the, herding all the cats. I would also like to put you on the spot as well, saying you got a couple of words you'd like to share with us?
I would just like to say thank you to everyone for participating and taking time out of your Sunday to be a part of this. And it's just something special we do every year, and happy to be here.
Yeah, thanks for putting it together.
So with that said, we shall go ahead and proceed to the procession. Takemikazuch, if you're in channel, I'm assuming we're heading to the usual spot for fireworks.
In front of Grommash Hold, yes, sir.
If anyone's, this is your first time here, what we do is we go ahead and do a march to Orgrimmar. So we'll just be walking along. It's you go ahead and hit the slash key so that you're doing a walk instead of a run. And we kind of go into Orgrimmar, and then there's a big fireworks show. And Lake, are you at the head of the parade?
Actually, if Beefmaster is in this raid team, I would like him to lead it this year.
All right, Beef, follow the master.
Okay, I don't think I'm in the raid group, but okay. I'm the guy in the white shirt.
The folks in my raid team, I'll put a star on myself and I'll be turning into a giant dragon.
How do you toggle walk?
It's
slash.
Above your numlock.
Slash on the number pad.
This is BrewDog. I'll just make a quick couple of things mentioned. I just want to remember my friend Borgaz, who I raided with a couple of teams, and a WoW member. There's a link in my comment if you want to see the forum thread on the AIE forums when he passed. And
I was going to add, if you know an individual who was in the guild and has passed, we actually do have a guild remembrance page on the wiki. Please feel free to add their information there, screen caps and whatever like information you're comfortable sharing about them.
Okay, I'll see if he may already have been mentioned on there. I'll check again. And then just a little aside, it's you know, I knew that we had a guildie that had a lung removed this several years ago, and there was some real concern about he had passed, and I just for the heck of it launched my went and got the Battle.net launcher and see if I can see when the last time he logged in a WoW, and just looking at, and he's online. I mean, he's no longer with AIEs, but just interesting to see that, and encouraging to see that someone's still around. That's all.
So, the balloons, another little story, if you'd indulge me. We had a member in our guild called Vandalclaw, also known as the Panda Guy. He was a furry. He would dress up as a panda. And he used to do it to go ahead and cheer up children with debilitating conditions and who were terminal. And he was diabetic and had been fighting a long, long fight with diabetes, and unfortunately finally succumbed to renal failure. But, you know, he would oftentimes said, and, you know, I remember writing him with him for a couple of times, he would say, everyone treats me like such a, like this weird anomaly, strange thing. I get made fun of, joked around. But, you know what? I don't get that here. Everyone's, you know, yes, what I do is strange to people's eyes, but no one pokes fun of me, no one makes fun of it. It's just, dude, you're playing a game with us.
This is Mentus. I have a picture in Mumble there if you want to see a picture of Vandalclaw right there, linked.
This is Grimcow. While we have a large collective audience, it was mentioned that we did have a wedding yesterday. In real life, Cyrene and Cutta were wed. And this coming Saturday, we will be celebrating said nuptials in the cathedral in Stormwind. So I hope to see you all.
I got it.
We need a large crowd.
Yeah. I remember getting an invite to that wedding saying to me,
body.
Oh dear.
Whoa.
Robot Lank has taken over. Jinx.
He has become a transformer.
New game Berserk.
Lank, don't give in!
Keep trying, buddy.
Domo arigato, Mr. Roboto.
Operator Murphy.
Do not disassemble.
Drop your weapon.
Guys, keep it kinda
behaved. While he tries to fix that, if anybody has, you know, something that they want to say, like slash say who you're walking for, it doesn't have to be a guild member. It could be a family member. It could be whatever. Like, this is a time where everybody's here for you. They might not see it depending where they are in the long line that we're in, but it's just kind of a to get stuff off your chest, share, you know, whatever you need to do memory-wise.
I have a little something I'd like to share, if that's all right.
As long as there's no puns involved.
No, I'm being 125% serious this time. And I hope this does not put anybody into a fit of tears. If it does, I apologize in advance for this, but there's a little poem here that I wanted to take and share, and I think this would be really fitting. For some of you who have played on the Alliance side, and I know there's probably some traitor mumbles going on here, guilty, in Shadowrath, if you've been looking around in all the nooks and crannies, you might come across a player named Kaylee. Believe it or not, this is an in-game memorial for a player by the name of Drac Kraus, who died in 2007 of leukemia at age 28. It's part of a quest chain called Alicia's Poem. A petition was made to Blizzard by a player named Alicia, who modified this poem and had it added into the game. So if you're on the Alliance side, go to Stormwind, look for a player named Alicia. She'll give you the quest, Alicia's Poem. Deliver it to Kaylee, and you'll have the poem read back to you. And I actually have a written version here. It's a variation of the poem, Do Not Stand at My Grave and Weep, which was written by Mary Elizabeth Fry in 1932. So there's a little bit of a WoW modification, but I think it's pretty good. So here we go. It goes a little something like this. Do not stand at my grave and weep. I am not there. I do not sleep. I am in a thousand winds that blow across Northern's bright and shining snow. I am the gentle showers of rain on Westfall's fields of golden grain. I am in the morning hush of Stranglethorn's jungle, green and lush. I am in the drums, loud and grand, the thunderous hooves across Nagrand. I am the stars warming gleamly over Darnassus, softly dreaming. I am in the birds that sing. I am in each lovely thing. Do not stand at my grave and cry. I am not there. I do not die.
Very nice. Thank you.
That was beautiful. Thank you.
An OMF.
Hey, this is Abavan here. If you give me 2 minutes, I have something to say. I just gotta finish something up, housewise.
We're timing you.
Hey guys and gals, this is Markonen, and as some of you know, I don't play on my troll mage over here very often, but I was able to go to Nerdtacular last week and had a really, really great time getting to meet a bunch of new guildies and make a lot of new friends. And it's times like these where not only we remember those that have fallen before us and those we carry on for, but we also remember why we are here with each other. And I just wanted you guys to know that even though I play on my gnome a lot, in my chest beats the heart of a troll and of an AIE member.
See, proof positive that I can indeed crash a Mac.
Skill.
Welcome back.
It was probably a good thing you were not here for the poem I just read, Lank, or I'd have you unleashing the waterworks like everybody else.
Oh, God.
And thank you, Mark, on it.
You're welcome.
You were going to say something about Sai's wedding, Lank?
Before I got cut off, I was going to say, I was hoping, again, I wasn't able to go because of work, but that's always one of the things, because I would have really loved to have gone to that wedding. There was an officer of ours also not too long ago who also got married too. So it's like I appreciate the invitations, and I really want to go most of the time, and I'll usually send you like a card or something afterwards. But it's like, man, if it weren't for work and school right now.
It's okay. We still love you.
Love you, too.
Sai!
Hey, Sai.
Hey, Sai.
You're
here! Congratulations.
Jinx.
Congratulations, Sai!
I owe someone a Coke.
Hey, this is Abavan here. If I could say a few words here.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
All right. For those who don't know, I am Abavan of many games. Most recently, Final Fantasy, but I can be found dabbling in a little bit of everything. For those who don't know, my wife and I, we lost our daughter in 2014, and it was very challenging for us, but there was a lot of support from the AIE gaming community. There was some words said last year, thank you for those, but the outpouring of the companionship and the love from everyone here was tremendous. And for someone who's lost a child, it's not something you get over, but the actually knowing that I have my an extension of my family here within playing a bunch of video games together is really for someone like me, it's very helpful for me to have. And for that, I'm eternally grateful to each and every one of you. So thank you.
Thanks for being here.
So I am totally going to rip off a line from a member from another gaming community. Yes, they exist, believe it or not. So a lot of you know me from WoW and also now in EVE. And in EVE, there's a thing called the meta. Basically, it's the game outside the game, the mental aspect, the kind of the underhanded unruliness that goes on, the subterfuge. And there was a speech he gave not too long ago, and in that speech he said that EVE has people called EVE as people have said, like space, spreadsheets in space, actuary tables in space. And he said something very interesting and important. He said, EVE is a terrible, horrible game. It is even worse single player game. But what EVE is a relationship manufacturer, in that it's not about the game. It's about the relationships you foster both in and outside the game that make it interesting, that keeps it compelling, which would usually turn a very, very mediocre, or even in some cases a very, very good game, boring. So the takeaway in all this is, remember, is that it doesn't matter how good and or how bad a game is. It's the relationships and the friendships and the interactions that you engage in that's actually the important thing.
The community.
Yep. Everything else is frosting.
Great, now I want frosting. Thanks, Link.
Cupcakes.
You know what's really good with frosting?
Bacon.
Well, that too, but I was going to say peanut butter.
That it is. Did you try my peanut butter cupcakes, Link?
Oh, the peanut butter. Oh, have you seen the peanut butter chocolate bacon cupcakes that are now,
yes,
like, making
around?
Yes, I have.
Around? I made those. I made those, like, a month ago. Those were amazing. My family wants me to make more.
If it is possible for me to step in for a moment, it's Talk. Could I ask all the people on the fireworks team to currently break off from the main group and make their way to their designated spots? And, Lank, if you could you steer Beefmaster a little bit if he happens to deviate? He was sort of sort of keeping an eye on me a little bit, so. I know he's got it, though.
I'll run up in front.
Roger that.
I am behind him and to his right.
Perfect.
So, you guys can totally talk, you know, and share stories. Some would even say it's tradition.
I got
not to cry, man. Come on.
On the topic of babies, we're expecting twins in about a month and a half.
Congratulations!
Oh, congratulations!
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 Congratulations! We're planning on bringing the babies to Nerdtacular, so we'll see you there as long as you get your shots, because they'll be about.
Do you know the sex you're going to do the surprise thing?
Oh, God, no. We're doing two girls.
Darn it. There goes my chance to get someone to name their child after my character.
It can still happen.
Your character is very girly to begin with, so I think it still works.
Oh, I think Lengtheris would be a perfect, like, middle name. Not to put him on the spot, but we can totally have a guild event to name his children.
You can try to, but they already have names.
Straw poll.
You get slash roll 100.
So I remember the various times we would do this event and people would, like, start yelling obscenities and make fun of AIE and such. And now it's like the thing is that we always took it in stride because they just didn't know. They didn't get it. So we'd like kill them with kindness and throw hugs around. Like I was mentioning earlier, I remember a day where we were the evil, the bane of people's existence, that we were the reason why they couldn't log in. The server was always full. We were sucking the marrow out of baby bones and who knows whatever kind of other malady or ailment that was afflicting WoW.
We did eat babies for a while.
We did.
Yeah, there was some guy on the forums who was always pushing the notion that somehow AIE had ruined this server. But he could never explain, like, exactly what was wrong with this server.
They never do.
Anyway, they're all gone now.
Well, there's a couple of guilds that are still around. And I whispered them and said, oh, you guys are still around. It's like, who are you people? Oh, you guys are from AIE. Yeah. Yeah, we just leave you guys alone. We learned a long time ago that we just should just give up.
Again, I think it's mostly due to this community that killing them with kindness, you know, they're not used to that. They're used to the vitriol coming right back at them.
Well, they're used to Reddit, like, you know, they're used to that kind of Reddit kind of culture with the one-upmanship, the if I yell or scream louder than you, I win.
4chan for the win.
Totally.
Yeah.
You know, I used to always tell people who weren't fitting in, it's like, you know, obviously this is not the community for you. Perhaps you need my assistance to find a place that you like and enjoy the, you know, better.
Also, a lot of those people were probably teenagers when they were doing that, and now they're, you know, it's 8 years later, right? They're
Storm Thuman. Remember Storm Thuman?
Yeah.
AKA, oh, I forget. For you folks who were newer to the guild, this server was notorious for a couple of trolls. One of them being was a fellow by the name of Storm Thuman, who I believe was forced to change his name because the name was too much like Strom Thurmond. And he was the resident troll, market manipulator, you know, hater of all things. And for the most part, he gave us wide berth until one day he decided to, it wouldn't be funny if I went in and joined AIE and tried to destroy it.
Good luck.
Which is kind of hilarious on the face of it.
No, I'm not saying that he got wrecked, but I'm saying that he got wrecked. Killed by hugs and kindness.
Well, he had such a recognizable sort of way of being that we pretty much figured out who he was within like a week. But, you know, didn't tell him that we knew who he was. So he was still...
A week? You're being generous, my friend. We knew in like 24 hours.
But he kept, you know, pretending, because there's this thing that Randy actually said, which is, if you ask someone, if you suspect someone with Storm Thuman, and you ask them if they are, and they say, who's that? I never heard of that person. Then it's him.
Yes.
Because everybody else on the server knows who he is.
Sounds familiar to somebody we have in SWTOR.
There's one in every server in every game, and in Eve, there's an entire community based of those people.
Hey, those people, as long as they're polite and friendly, I'll take them.
It's a whole different kind of crazy over there.
I've been playing Heroes of the Storm recently, and you know, you get matched up with whoever. And I had forgotten about this whole side of the community that, they think they win by calling you names, and it's now I just find it hilarious.
Taka, do you want us up the bridge or inside the?
Inside, please, sir. Grommash, hold.
Gotcha.
And if I can have a couple of moments, I had a request from Zephy. Sorry, Zephy, didn't mean to put you on the spot. she asked if I could mention something. She'd like to mention her friend Kristen, who passed away 3 years ago to cancer.
Wow. How come I'm phased out? What happened?
Oh, we entered town.
It'll come back once you go in.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
Welcome to phasing technology. Not exactly always the perfect thing. So I have this vision, this plan. You know, we do coups, and now coups are, for the most part, pretty straightforward. But I always had this notion that, you know, since you can bring other people from other raids, other servers to your raid, to one day have a colossal mega raid from folks from not only our server, but several other servers. and just completely and totally and utterly decimate the Alliance for half a day.
I'm down.
Yeah, there's a surprise, Grim.
I just need to find out if it's doable. And who do I let know at Blizzard that the mother of all, like, coop runs may be happening?
If you had been there last week, you could have mentioned it to Russell, and he probably would have made it happen.
Not Russell, the crit Metzen. Oh, trust me, they know. They know.
Standing there at Nerdtacular, talking with the guy who's written the games I've played for 20 years.
You were there talking to the voice of Thrall, my friend.
I was talking absolutely to the voice of the Battlecruiser. Battlecruiser operational.
Believe it or not, I met Chris a couple times, and he is like the world's, like, okay, he's like the best looking dork I've ever known.
Listen to him on the comics panel. He's quite the nerd.
Oh, yeah.
He's a geek like us, man. That's the funny thing about it.
I think Lank's got a man crush.
Totally, man.
Is he a brony?
Believe it or not, he is. But then again, like, half of Blizzard Entertainment is like our bronies. If you ever get a chance to visit and they get a tour, the number of, like, My Little Pony paraphernalia, I mean, they actually have, like, full-on, like, nerd fights, nerd slap fights, or whether who's better, Rainbow Dash or Rarity.
Applejack.
That's probably why they have the cute little level in Diablo.
She who said Applejack, you are totally wrong.
No, Princess, I'm not wrong, Link. I will go to your house.
Princess Luna, best pony.
It's on now, man.
Princess Moonbutt for the win.
Definitely Luna.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, boys.
see, Akizad is this in the channel, and Zod, I made this brew dog. I still use your technique for line of sight pulls. Everybody sits in a corner, and whenever the mobs come around, we all yell surprise.
That's awesome. I like that.
I'm stealing that too, just so you know.
That's hilarious.
All the guys on my current team. There's a few of us in the. In the comms can verify that I actually do that to this day. Every line of sight pull.
Now we know where it comes from. All right.
Yep. From pulling the trash before Sindragosa.
Yeah. Blame Accuzon.
Have you ever noticed the number of, like, community-specific, like, puns and memes we've created?
Yeah, it's always funny. Someone will say something and they have no idea what they're talking about, where that came from.
It's like, to this very day, I can't say the word banana hammock without laughing like a little moronic boy.
I don't think anybody can, really.
Or people trying to pronounce my character's name and all they come up with, I'm just going to call you Larry. What the heck?
I'm still going with the wrestler Takamichi Noku.
Taking my zucchini.
That one did.
And banana hammock now is being used in Star Wars in one of the ups.
Oh yeah.
It's pretty much universal to AIE at this point.
Yes.
Where does it come from? Wow. You know what? It's nice to have Ogrimmar all to ourselves.
I believe that the Jabba the Hutt had a banana hammock.
I remember it first being used in the Guppers.
Yeah, I think that's right.
Ooh, I can see a lot of people down there. Holy smokes.
We're here.
Alrighty, in that case, we will not tarry. For those of you who have been here before, you know the routine, but for some of those that have not been here, We set off a little fireworks display every year during the Memorial Day to take and celebrate our friends that have passed on. And it is a pleasure to take and do this every year when I get asked by the officers to take and do it. The materials that are used to make these fireworks and the launchers are made by
you guildies, and holy moly, when you guys make these things up, I mean, you really make them up. I've still got two bank tabs on an alt full of nothing but fireworks. So I think I'm pretty well stocked up for the next, I don't know, 5, 6, 7, 8 years maybe. So without further ado, we shall take and get this started. Fireworks team, you may begin.
What is it, the crazy laughter?
If only someone had that dancing piccolo. Anyone got a train?
You had to say something, Link. You had to say something.
Fireworks team, prepare for finale. Large rocket clusters in 3, 2, 1, now.
You can hit the blimp.
Hope it's got insurance.
Oh, the humanity!
Oh, yeah.
That's awesome.
Nice job.
Fireworks team, all stop.
Is it time for a vortex of love?
Love vortex in 3, 2, 1, go.
Fireworks team, join the shenanigans.
Shenanigan!
If you cannot fly because you're low level, find a buddy who has a two-person mount.
Either that or jump on land because he's a rideable dragon.
I'd say something to that, but I'm going to bite my tongue.
I'm on the ground if someone needs a ride as well.
Well, so considering there are a lot of officers in here, and I ain't gonna roll that dice.
I need to ride somebody so I can take screenshots.
Hey, Sean, come on.
Just follow somebody.
Him, that's what she said.
I'm glad somebody else said it, not me.
Shoulder, you got a tail.
Alright, folks. Thank you again for making it. We will see you in game soon. I need to go take the wife out to dinner.
Smart move.
Yay! Also, I'd like to thank the ones who helped out with the fireworks in that tonight. Tinchel, Bristol, Didius, Liriana, and Roshinko, thank you very much.
Thank you for anyone who make it. Yeah,
thanks, guys.
And don't forget, you guys, this sets up for the week of Summer of Love, so check the forums and the Twitter for events and different games throughout the week.
Yep.
Yes, this vortex is going to make an entire love thing.
Thanks, everyone who organized this.
Thanks, Greg.
Thank you.
This year, it's totally Beefmaster's fault. Send all love mail to Beefmaster at beefmasterisawesome.com.
Nice to see you in the right game again.
Have a great night, everyone. Thanks for taking time out of your Sunday for us.